Okay, hi. I hope I can be heard. Then. Is the title set? Yes. And we get back to reading Scrooge. This time we are at chapter 10. And to recap a bit, Scrooge has finally found struck gold on the Klondike and made his start a fortune. He then came back to Scotland to try out living there, back in his homeland, but he didn't fit in there anymore. So he dug up a deed he has bought on his travels, and that brings him back to America, where he targets for Duckburg. And so we dive right in into the part of 1902, and we can already see on the covers the Beagle Boys make a reappearance. So, okay. The Life and Times of Scrooge McDuck, Part 10, The Invader of Fort Duckburg. Having made $1 billion in the Yukon, Scrooge McDuck has decided it's time to establish a home base from which to build a world financial empire. To that end, he has left Scotland with his sisters, Hortensie and Matilda, and is headed for a plot of land he owns on America's west coast, near a tiny settlement called Duckburg. The Calisota countryside is stoutly serenaded by a strange shape moving along the dusty back roads. Damn. Oh, Scroogey, quit crapping. I can't help it. I never should have bought this infernal contraption. How come you didn't know it only runs on a mixture of kerosene and whale oil? Didn't you read the fine print? I couldn't see the fine print. 6 years of the Yukon show all but ruined my eyes. I'm not even sure what was the rest of the list of costly options I rejected. We are lost too. I'd better stop and ask that farmer for directions to Fort Duckburg. Ask him if there are any handsome cowboys around. Old Fort Duckburg? The place is falling apart and the land is too steep to grow crops. I don't want a real estate seminar, just directions. Well, there's your fort up there on top of Kilmore Hill. Thanks. There's Duckburg, wide as it's tall. And no cowboys, where are all the big American cowboys? There's the owner's manual for the buggy. Rose Regal options. Ah, oh, come on, you Weasen T-Bot. Go, go, go. Whoops. Mercy, one of the options declined was brakes. Good. When Scrooge McDuck is on the move, he never stops. Well, big shot, you're moving downhill now. Yes, breaking into a backing into a parking space. Our big brother, the snowblind billionaire. From now on, you wear your spectacles full time. That runaway flavor just missed me. Yes, Stefan, your incredible luck saved us all. Saved you, as usual. Need to rename it to Killmotor Hill for in the new auto age. Excuse me, I need a place to store a worthless motor car. Well, I'll sell you a shed out on Corn Tassel Road. I own most all of the land hereabouts. Not that hill. I bought it from a showdop up in Whitehorse. Then you must be Scrooge McDuck. My brother Casey told me he sold you that land. My name is Elvira, and this is my husband Dabney, and two of our young'uns, Dafan and Ada. Folks just call us Mon Pa Duck. Oh, quaint. Yep, that fort is where my grandpappy Cornelius Coot established a settlement and formed his woodchuck militia. Well, it's where I'm building my world headquarters. What a shame the local boys' club is using it as the clubhouse. Boys' club? Something my father Clintwood Coot founded, the Junior Woodchucks. Running off freeloaders is one of my hobbies. Oh, here comes our other boy, Quackamore. When he sees this mess, he will throw his usual tantrum. Whack! Who wrecked the corn? Don't worry, my sister Hortensi can top out any tantrum tosser in town. I ought to bring somebody's neck. Ah, who cares about your stupid corn cups? You snotty brat, you got a half-minded mind to get a horse whip and tan your flanks. Half a mind is half you have, you mangy hayseed. Land sakes, I've never seen Quackamore out quacked before. Maybe he finally found himself a gal. Oh, spare me. Come along, Hortense, we need to root out those pigeon groundhogs. Junior Woodchucks. Bye, Quackypoo. Maybe someday I will be called Grandma Duck. I shudder to imagine the kid that would come from that unholy union. Soon, near the summit of Killmotor Hill. Snap out of it, Hortense. You never see me with such a goofy, mesmerized expression. Oh no! Just wait till I pull a nickel out where you can see it. Never mind, we are here to inspect this dilapidated Fort Duckboat. What a wreck! Careful. I've spent enough time on the world's largest, wildest frontiers to know that the earliest settlers were a rough and a ready bunch. They may have set hideous booby traps as defenses against the attackers by insurgents. Horrors! Our poor brother, in the very prime of his life, when suddenly, without warning, drenched, oh cruel fate! Alright, alright. Somebody is coming. Duckburg, charter troop, prepare to repel invader. Ah, the midget gophers. Junior Woodchucks. This is my property. Get off my land, now! General Fulton, we have lost our clubhouse. Notify the rest of our worldwide organization. He knows, General Billy. He's right behind me. Hey! Take this big ugly book with you. General Tommy, you're the keeper of the Junior Woodchuck guidebook this week. Oh no, please, it's so heavy. Someday we just got to make a pocket-sized copies of this monster. And you run chipmunks can stare out. Junior, Woodstock. Woodchuck. Never mind. This is an ideal spot for my home base. Now we can head back to the train depot and get my money barrels. But not even the earliest woodchucks are so easily discouraged. What do we do now, man? Disband? Never. How do we know that guy is really owns for Duckburg? Right, he could be a crook and an enemy agent. We better write to the authorities. Remember the main. Times being what they were, nervous of local officials sent the letter to the governor, who panicked and forwarded it straight to Washington. And soon, Mr. President, a telegram from Calisoda, from the Woodchucks? Ah, the state militia. Brave lads, rode with me at San Jose Ridge. They say a billionaire from Scotland has seized a military installation on the coast. Great jumping, Jehoshaphat. The three dangers that I campaign strongest against. Big business, foreign interference, and military threats on our shores. All rolled into one. Agat! I will handle this personally. Reactivate my first volunteer cavalry unit. Yes, sir. Yes, by Godfrey. The Rough Riders will ride again. Oh, sorry. I have to... Excuse that, there was something messaging me. Okay, back in Calisota, a week later, a flatboat drifts lazily down the Tolbuck River. And you silly girls wanted me to pay a tram set to haul my money to Fort Duckburg. See how easy it is to float this year? And free, too. I'm just thankful Duckburg isn't upriver from the train depot. How much further, Scroogey? I'm about to drop from all this lack of effort. Not far, I think, but I would better ask that home trader to be sure. And find out where all the good-looking cowboys are hiding. Hello? Anyone home? Scram, we ain't got your dang chickens. Besides, you got... No proof. Oops, excuse me, heavy lunch. I just want to know how far it is to Duckburg. We never been there. Anybody's in Duckburg who's missing a pig can look somewhere else. Oink, oink, oink. Oink, we didn't hear no oink. I'll skip it. Psst. Pa, look who that was. Let me see. Get that dang mule out of the way. Don't trip over the goat. Holy hell, it's Scrooge McDuck. That feisty runt we knew back from our Mississippi pirate days. So he's moving to Calisota too? What a deal. We can pay him back for getting us tossed in a horse goo. Whose girl? 22 years ago. Yeah, first stretch we ever did. Let's go, Pa. Pay him a visit. You bet we will. Ma, if a boss comes up and tell him you don't know nothing about the missing cattle herd, you think they'll believe me? Later. One more barrel, and my whole binion will be inside a vault. Then I'll start planning out the foundation for a proper storage vault. Ah, here comes the last barrel now. Isn't this wonderful, girls? Fresh air, exercise, and you're getting paid 10 cents an hour. I can't believe you take the advantage of your relatives like that. Oh, well, I swear I'll never do it again. Maybe. Anyway, how about a refreshing bath after all that work? Oh yes, that would be heavenly. No, Matilda, he means his kind of bath. Pathetic, just pathetic. Someone's at the gate. If it is a traveling salesman, I hope it's his insurance is paid up. Hortensi, come quick. It's our first cowboy caller. And who do you think it is? Buffalo Bill? The Sundance Kid? The Lone Stranger! It's 4 lone strangers. 2 for each of us. This is the land of opportunity. Next, we're looking for Scrooge McDuck. That's him, bathing in those barrels of money. And it's not even Sunday night. I wonder why. Barrels of what? Money! Barrels of money! That poor little river rat. A millionaire? Billionaire, actually. Whack! The Beagle Boys! You blackguards, release us! We should have known you were imposters. After all, 4 lone strangers and a single tune too? Here we wasted 20 years stealing chickens and hawks while McDuck was busy gathering this trove. All of us. What a guy. We should have stuck with you, Scrooge boy. You damn. Get off my land now. Scrooge, help. Help. Forget it, Toots. He'll never get out of the battle. He's at our mercy. What the Sam Hill? That was an artillery shell. Scrooge must have made some powerful enemies since we saw him last. Attention to the fort. Surrender or die. Oh, Doc, that has a bad ring to it. Now what? Great balls of fire. It's the Navy. And the Marines. And even the Dwarf Voles. Junior Woodchucks. But who is the big shot with the megaphone? This is the President of the United States. Your time is up. What? I'll say Scrooge has made some powerful enemies. With his personality, I'm not surprised. No microbe moles or beagle boys or even the President can push me around. Get off my land now, Junior Woodchucks. Now you've done it. They'll blow us to kingdom come. I'm too be young to be shelled by a navy. Hey, big sissies. I finally have an adversary to almost match me. Woohoo! Charge! The historic charge upon Kilmoder Hill. Surrender, McDuck, before we are all killed. You can't fight. What can you use for weapons? The only thing I've got, the fort itself. I will throw this termite-eaten old dump on them stick by stick if I have to, until I'm defending a bare mound of dirt. Attention, men! Watch out for the nerf turret. What do you mean, sir? A sniper? No, I mean what I said. Watch out for the nerf turret. Here it comes. Bully, I've tagged many a fort, but this is the first time a fort ever attacked me. Interrogating. Forward, men, follow me. Drat, that crazy duck locked the gates. Help, we surrender. Save us, and we'll all vote for you next year. I'll vote for you twice. What now, sir? Remember what I always say, man. Speak softly, but carry a big stick of dynamite. Prepare to storm the breach gates. Watch out for the west turret, sir. Why, is there a sniper in? Come at me, yeah, monkeys. It will be a dark day when I give up my mare to a male superpower. That does it. I've had it all. Gonna take you from these boorish American cow people. Hortensi, mind your temper. The historic retreat down the Kilmotor Hill. Ah, look out! There's girls on Spitfire. Do something. Like what? We can't shoot an unarmed lady. Ah, please, Sarge, just as once. Sounds, I must try this tactic on the Congress. Undaunted, I shall press on single-handedly. No foreign tycoon warmonger will evade Fort Duckburg. And so their two greatest men of their day meet in a head-to-head fight to the finish. Who will blink first, the guy who made it square or the guy who dealt it square? Why, you are Buck McDuck from Montana. And you are that ranger I've met years ago in the Dakota Badlands. I thought you were some cowardly interloper. How absurd. I never guessed you ended up president. Well, you have done almost as well as I have. Hortensi, you didn't hurt any of these poor Rough Riders, did you? Rough Riders? What Rough Riders? You know what Rough Riders, the ones I had to pull you off before you whacked them, silly. I'll go tell your turnips, your bumpkin, nobody ask you to meddle. Do I hear wedding bells or do I? I almost made a tragic mistake, Buck. Why didn't you answer my first hail? I was having some momentary trouble with those crooks. Allow me, you boys go find an unwhacked Rough Rider and tell him I put you under arrest. Wow, you bet? Imagine, arrested by the President of the United States. That will tell. Wait till we tell more. And when we get out of jail, we'll know where Scrooge will be with all that money. But are just the four of us a match for that, Duck? You boys need to start raising families. We need more beagle boys. You guys seen a gal with a broom? That evening, the two great men discuss great adventures over a presidential campfire. And this is how I won the Battle of Santiago. Great, but let me tell you about the time in the Transvaal, when it was so hot, the gold oozed like taffy. I've always dreamed that when our brother became a billionaire, we would attend a dinner party with the President of the United States. But I never pictured it like this. And I whacked my way through the wall of a human flesh, dragging my canoe behind me. Bully, bully, delightful. Scrooge, I owe you my success to you. I've never gotten back into politics, if not for your coaxing. And you taught me the glory of hard work and to always be a square dealer. The result is my first billion. Soon I'll build a suitable fortress for that seat of an empire. 6 months later. And that seed will grow and spread and bear fruit. And someday, this 3-cubic-acre bin will fill up, and my money will near the top of the gorge. Sure, Scrooge, your old canoeic dragging story was more likely. What's more, once I start building industry around Duckburg, this one-horse town will grow into a mighty city. Look, the junior woodchucks. Sorry. If your boys hadn't called the government last year, those beagles might have gotten away with my money. May I make a donation toward your new clubhouse? Jeepers, sure. A used doorknob? Duckburg will never be the same with Mr. McDuck around. Not be a judge fool. Not by a chuck fool. Hey buddy, I heard some tycoon moved in to the town and there's gonna be lots and lots of new jobs. That's right. Well, Mabel, this is where we built our homestead. But not near that thing. That's a monstrosity. You better get used to that monstrosity, ma'am. It is here to stay. Why, you metalhead? What sort of stupid name for a kid is that, Arnold? Your son of mine, no son of mine will ever be a mad. You can obviously see that Temperate Hortensie is the mother of Donald. And with that, we catched up another chapter. I will be making a short break and cut, and then we get to bonus chapter 10.5. So there are only two more to go. Yeah. See you in a few.